Good morning, Bear Valley Church. My name is Hunter, and I want to welcome you here to service this morning. So I have a couple announcements for you guys before we get started. And first things first, we want to talk about life groups. We want to kick off life groups in a big way, starting out for our Christmas series. And in order to do so, we need life group leaders. If you're interested in being a life group leader, either join us on Tuesday, November 17th for two different meetings. We are going to have a meeting at 5 p.m. and 7 p.m. because we know everybody's schedule is a little bit different. So you can either join us at 5 or 7 p.m. on Tuesday, November 17th. You will have to RSVP for those meetings. So either text bvc.groups to 77948 or email our life groups guy, Matt, at lifegroups@bvcbigbear.org. Along with that, did you know that there's three different ways that you can watch church in the morning? If you didn't, now you do. You can either join us on Facebook starting at 10 a.m. on Sundays on our Facebook page, or if you want to watch church whenever you want, you can either from our website or from our app, either bvcbigbear.org or Bear Valley Church Big Bear. You can download that from the Apple App Store or Google Play Store. Otherwise, we're gonna go ahead and get started. I think the band's getting warmed up in there. So go ahead and sit back, relax, and join us as we worship together.
There is a light that breaks through the darkness. There is a hope that washes the fear away. There is a peace that settles around us. It is a love that sets our hearts ablaze. Father, we're on our knees with every heartbeat. We bring you this offering. Lord, come and fill this place. Father, we're crying now. Spirit, we need you now. Glorious love surrounds us. Lord, come and fill this place. Sing, there's a King. There is a King that reigns in victory. There's a mercy. There is a mercy strong enough to save. We feel it rising up from the ashes. It is your love that overcame the grave. There is a love that overcame the grave.
You, I will worship you. Count on one thing, the same God who never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name. Oh, yes, I will sing for joy when my heart is heavy. Oh, my days. Oh, yes, I will. Same God who never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who never late is working all things out. Working all things out. Yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will lift you high.
Lord, we lift up this praise to you. God, that we can sing your praise in the valleys. Lord, we can proclaim your name no matter what season we are going in, no matter what is going on in our life. God, with all this craziness going on, Lord, we know that we can give it to you. God, we can cast our cares upon you. God, that is what you call us to do. So Lord, in this season, God, I pray that our hearts would be open. God, our hands would be open to you. God, we would be in surrender of who you are. Lord, we give you this time. God, we sing your praise, for you are so worthy. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Well, hello, everybody. My name is Matt Harris, and I want to welcome you to part three of our sermon series, a series we called Reset, Reestablishing Firm Foundations. This is a series that gets its foundation from Psalm 62:6 that says, truly, he is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress, and I will not be shaken. In this series, we're taking a look at five worship songs and using them to recalibrate and reset our minds on who God is and who we are to him. We're using them to reset and focus on God first. Well, you might remember in the first part of the series, I talked about the song, Good, Good Father. I used it as the beginning of our quest to reestablishing that foundation and that relationship with Christ, right? I talked about how we all tend to make things so much more difficult than they are. We do it so much in our normal everyday lives that naturally we bring it into our relationship with God. I ended that message with a reminder to keep it simple, that God is a good, good Father and we are loved by him. Last week, in the second part of our series, Pastor Michael talked about the song Here Again and how God meets us here and now. He talked about the fact that we can't do anything about the past. We have no idea what the future is going to hold. So we need to focus on here and now. But more importantly, we need to focus on the fact that God meets us right here where we are. Well, this week we're going to continue our series with a song I'd never heard before, but it really spoke to me when Pastor Chris played it for me in our planning sessions. It's a song about praising God even when we're in the depths of our lowest valleys. But before we get going, let me pray for us. Father God, thank you so much for this time that we get to spend together, Lord. I thank you for the technology that allows this to happen, Father God. I thank you for your words. I thank you for your son. Father, speak through me and open hearts and open minds to what you have for them today. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, here we are. We're in the third part of our series. We've had an election. We're still in the middle of this pandemic, and we've had our first snowfall for the season. Now, when I moved here from Illinois back in 2005, I thought I'd never shovel snow again, and I was incredibly wrong. There's still a whole lot of uncertainty and a whole lot of anger surrounding us, but despite everything that's going on, we still have a Father who is not shaken. We have a God that gives us a firm foundation to stand on no matter what we're going through. I mean, folks, we can use that knowledge and rest in it. We can use that knowledge and reset our minds and hearts on what matters most. When we started the planning sessions for this series, I got really, really excited. And let me tell you why. I spent most of my working career behind a desk pushing paper in customer service and at night playing my guitar thinking I was going to be a rock star, right? Sure, I was going to church. I was volunteering at church. I was leading a life group. But the majority of my time was spent pushing paper from my inbox to my outbox. A job had no real meaning. I never became a rock star, and I was burnt out and I needed a change. So the planning meeting for this series was my first after coming on staff here at the church. And instead of pushing paper, we were talking about how to teach God's word and teach it in a time that none of us had ever been a part of before. To top it off, we were talking about how to do it with music. As a musician and as a Christ follower, I was jumping. I was excited. Then Pastor Michael asked me if I was ready to preach. And in my outside voice, I said, yes! While the whole time, my inside voice, I was going, who in God's name thinks that I'm ready to preach right now? Yeah, I've spoken in front of groups. I've had the obligatory PowerPoint behind me with my little laser pointer, right? I've played my guitar in front of tons of people, singing sometimes too. You know, in the last few years, I've flown around the Western United States teaching other people how to do what I was doing. I was pushing paper. Yeah, I'm actually going to school right now to do what Pastor Michael was asking me to do. But was I ready? And then to top all of that off, he asked me to kick off the series. Well, I did that 2 weeks ago. And I was throwing a softball of a song to sing, right? I was singing Good, Good Father, a song about how much God loves us and how good he is. That's the fun part about preaching, when everything is going great. Everything, life is good, but life isn't always a smooth ride with the windows down and the radio up. Sometimes life hurts. Sometimes it's not so sunny, and sometimes we're stuck on the side of the road in the pouring rain with a flat tire. That brings us to today's song. The song is called Yes, I Am. You just heard us play it a few minutes ago. Pastor Chris and I were sitting in the office, kicking around songs, playing back and forth songs, trying to find a second song for me to preach. And he played this song for me. And as I started reading the lyrics and I started listening to the words, the music, I knew that this was going to be a perfect song for me to sing. One, because just like Good, Good Father, it was a simple song. The verses and chorus repeat multiple times. The message is completely clear. But number two, also like Good, Good Father, it helps with that firm foundation to build on. Vertical Worship is the band that wrote the song. And in a video talking about where the song came from, they said it revolves around Psalm 34:1. And if you have your Bibles or if you have the church app, why don't you turn to Psalm 34:1 with me and follow along. Psalm 34:1 is where David says, I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. It's this idea that we should always be praising God, whether we're in the good times or the bad times. It was after watching that video, I started to think about the valleys that I have traveled in my life, how I handled them before coming to Christ and how I've handled them since. And I started thinking, was I really the guy to talk about this stuff? Because I don't know you all nearly well enough. But I do know that there are those of you out there that have valleys that make mine look like little dimples in the road. You've had wars, and I've had mild adventures by comparison. So who was I to start talking about the valleys and how to handle them in our life? Then God started asking me why I'm comparing my valleys, my dark roads, with anybody else's. We have all gone or will go through stuff, right? See, it's not about the valleys. The authors of the New Testament tell us we're going to have these valleys, right? James, in the first chapter of his book, says, count it all joy when we go through trials. In 1 Peter 5:7, Peter talks about casting all our anxieties on God. We're going to have anxieties. In Romans 12:12, Paul says, rejoice in hope, be patient in tribulation, and to be in constant prayer. So it's not about the valleys. Instead, it's what we do and who we turn to while traveling those dark roads that matter. And that's what verse 1 is about. And Chris is going to sing it for us right here.
I count on one thing. The same God who never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out.
Let's focus on the first half of that verse. The words are simple, right? I count on one thing. The same God who never fails will not fail me. You will not fail me. Now, you can tell that the author is having a bad time, right? This song is not a song about a happy place in his life. You can feel that the author is hurting and in need of God to show up. I know we've all been there. We've all been hurting. We've all been needing, and we've all been waiting for God to show up. But what we also see here is the confidence, the foundation that this singer has, the confidence in the words that God never fails and he won't fail in this instance. Does that mean everything is going to work out the way the author wants it to? No, that's just not how God works, but we can count on the fact that God is going to be here. You guys remember the movie Bruce Almighty with Jim Carrey? In his role as God, he starts to hear all these voices in his head, and he realizes these are the prayers of all the people that he's hearing, and they're driving him crazy. So he decides he needs to do something about it, right? So he puts them all in these file cabinets, and all these file cabinets show up, and so many that he can't even move in his apartment. Then he realizes this is a horrible thing. So he turns them into post-it notes, and I don't know about you, but I hate, I'm using the word hate here about post-it notes. But he puts all these post-it notes appear all over him, all over his dog, all over his girlfriend. They're everywhere. All these little yellow devils are everywhere. And he realizes that's not going to work. So he comes up with a plan to put them all in email. And so he sits down with his cup of coffee, freshly poured from the window from Juan Valdez, and he sits down and starts answering all of these emails, and he's answering, and he finally figures, he says, I must have made some kind of dent, and he realizes he's got even more emails. So he decided to answer them all with a yes. Well, if you remember what happens next in the movie, because every request was answered with a yes, utter chaos starts to break out in the movie. I mean, can you imagine? I mean, how many of you prayed that the Dodgers would win the World Series? How many of you prayed that they wouldn't? For the election, right? How could God possibly say yes to everything? Well, the second half of the verse says, in the waiting, the same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. That's Romans 8:28, right? And we know in all things, God works for the good of those who love him and who have been called according to his purpose. It's a great verse. It looks great on a sign or embroidered on a pillow. It makes a great Facebook post. But what is Paul talking about here? I can tell you he's not talking about giving you everything you want in your prayers. Paul is talking about how God is working in every circumstance in our lives. He's there in the good times and he's there in the bad. Remember, God knows the plans he has for you. God is working it all out for us. So he will say yes to some things, no to others. And at other times, he's just going to say, wait. Here's the takeaway I get from verse 1. God never fails. He's working everything out. That pain you feel now, that hurt, that joy, the laughter, the love you feel right now, God has it in his hands and he's in it with you. He's in it for you. We can set our feet on that foundation and not be shaken. While the verse sets up the foundation that we need to have in our lives, the chorus tells us how to build on that foundation. When you're building a house, you start with a foundation, but then you start adding walls and the electricity and the plumbing, everything you need to do to make it a house, right? Well, the chorus of this song is all about making a choice. In life, we have the choice to lift God high and sing for joy when we are in our lowest, or ignore God, turn away from his blessings. Chris is going to sing the chorus for us now.
Yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name. Oh, yes, I will sing for joy when my heart is heavy all my days. Oh, yes, I will.
Well, thanks, Chris. As I mentioned earlier, I'm currently in school. I'm going to Grand Canyon University, trying to earn my bachelor's degree in Christian ministry. God willing, I'm going to graduate in July of next year, and then I'm going to be moving on to my master's in divinity, all with the hopes of maybe being a pastor one day when I grow up. In one of my first classes, we were talking about rhetoric. Rhetoric is the art of persuasive speaking. Every speech you hear, every sermon you hear, every ad you hear is filled with rhetoric. Well, one of the speeches that we studied, one of the first speeches we studied is called This is Water by David Foster Wallace. It's a commencement speech to the graduating class of Kenyon College back in 2005. If you ever have the time to read it or listen to it, I highly recommend it, but I will mention David was not a Christian, and the speech is kind of PG-13, so just keep that in mind when you do it. In his speech, David talks about the grind that all of these graduates are about to step into, and I know you know the grind I'm talking about. You work all day at the office, and all you want to do is go home and sleep, but you can't. You got to go to the grocery store, where when you get there, you're going to get that cart with the wobbly wheel. And then you're going to get your groceries and you're going to get behind that guy that has 25 items and the 15 items or less. Then you're going to store it all in your car and you're going to sit in traffic all the way home. David says that these things are going to happen, but that's not the point of his speech. The point of his speech is that it's in these situations, in this junk, cleaned up that word, in this junk is where our choices come in. It's how we all have a choice in how we're going to respond in every situation. A choice in what we're going to do, how we're going to act, react. A choice in what we're going to say. Now, folks, if we know that God never fails, he will never fail, that God is never late and he's working all things out, and if we take the last two messages and we know that God is a good, good Father and he loves us and he meets us here and now, if we have that foundation to stand on, our choice is simple. It's yes, I will. We're going to lift God's name high when we're sinking, when we're in our lowest valleys, when things are just not going our way. We're going to lift him high when we or someone we know is sick, when we lose that job, that house. We have no idea how we're going to pay the bills. We're going to sing for joy when our hearts are heavy. I know all that's easy to say, but I also know that God is with us when we're hurting. He's our Father, and he's got his arms wrapped around us. And if we choose to respond when we're hurting, if we choose to lift him up and sing for joy at his name, we're going to feel those arms. We're going to feel that love. That brings us to the bridge of the song. The verse and the chorus repeat several times through the song, right? Until we get to the bridge. The bridge is like the part of the movie when you see the change happens, right? We've been going, the story's moving along this tension ladder, and we're waiting for something to break. It's like riding uphill on a roller coaster. It's chug, 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 and you get to the top, and oh, you finally see what's coming, where everything is going. Chris is going to sing the bridge for us right now.
And I choose to praise, to glorify, glorify the name of all lives. But nothing is stand against. And I choose to praise, to glorify, glorify the name of all lives. But nothing is stand against.
So in the course, we finished talking about the choice that we have to make. Here, the bridge says, I choose to praise, to glorify the name of all names that nothing can stand against. That's a declaration, people. It's a choice to choose God even when we're down. This is something you can repeat over and over and over. Sing it when you're feeling up. Sing it when you're feeling down. Sing it when you're stuck behind a truck doing 30 miles an hour up the hill that just refuses to pull over. Sing it when you're in the village on a Friday night and it's packed and all you want is some saucy mama's pizza. Scream it when you're facing adversity and scream it when you're riding high. I choose to praise, to glorify the name of all names. How can you not be lifted up? It's amazing. But as we're wrapping this whole thing up, let me leave you with 3 points. The first point is count on it. You ever heard that phrase before? You can count on it. You can count on me, right? You can count on God. He has not and he will not fail. What God says he will do, he will do. In Isaiah 14, 24, God says, as I have planned, so it shall be. And as I have purposed, so it shall stand. God knows what we're going through. Nothing surprises him, and he is working it all out for us. So count on it. Point two is decide you must. If you're a Star Wars fan, you're going to remember Yoda talking to young Luke Skywalker and say, he said, decide you must how to serve them best. Folks, we have to make a choice in how we're going to respond in every situation. Like Indiana Jones, we have to choose wisely. Remember, God has not and will not fail. He's always on time and he's always working things out for us. We have that firm foundation. Now, before we move on to point three, I have to disclose in full honesty that I am not a Star Wars fan. I know you can send your complaints to my email address at michael@bvcbigbear.org. Point three is sing it out. Folks, make this your daily prayer. Say, yes, I will. I remember when I came to the Lord in 2006. I remember a pastor talking about how Jesus died for our sins. Whenever I would get tempted or in a dark place, I would remember that. I would say, Jesus died for that. That was my reminder. This can be the same thing, right? It's a reminder of the foundation of the relationship that God wants with us. So sing it. Psalm 89:1 says, I will sing the Lord's great love forever. Psalm 132:9 says, sing to him, sing praise to him, tell him of all his wonderful acts. As we close out this message, I pray that you find comfort in knowing that our God will never fail and that he's working all things out. I pray that you find comfort in counting on God always. I praise that you choose to lift his name high in whatever you're going through. I hope you take this song and I hope you make it a theme song for this week and moving forward. Make sure you tune in next week for part four when Pastor Michael comes back. God bless. Have an amazing day.
God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out.